Today I'm going to make my presentation under the topic of the chronic anti-inflammatory activity of Sudarshana suspension on adjuvant-induced arthritis in cats. Before that, I would like to introduce my research team, Professor Gunasekera, Professor in Pediatrics, Faculty of Medical Sciences, University of Sudarshana, and Professor Sudarshana Suresh, Professor in Biochemistry, Faculty of Medical Sciences, University of Sudarshana, and Dr. Kamal Perera, the Senior Lecturer in Pharmacology and Pharmaceutics in IIT. I would like to touch these things as my outline: introduction, aim, methodology, research and discussion, conclusion, future scope, references, and acknowledgement. Let's move to the introduction. Inflammation is a complex biological response of vascular tissues to harmful stimuli, such as pathogens, damage cells, or irritants. It's a defensive mechanism aimed to remove the injured stimuli and initiate the tissue healing process. Adjuvant-induced arthritis is a chronic inflammatory disease characterized by the infiltration of synovial membrane and associated with the disruptions of the joint. It is resembles rheumatoid arthritis in human in terms of immunologically as well as the biochemically. This model is the widely used as a model for the therapeutic and pathogenic studies for the chronic form of inflammation. Let's move to the introduction of Sudarshana suspension. Before that, I would like to introduce the Sudarshana powder. I guess some of you may have heard about the Sudarshana powder because it is one of the most effective ayurvedic preparation widely used in Sri Lanka as well as in India. It is traditionally used as an antipyretic, anti-malarial, anti-inflammatory, and as well as the anti-viral formulation. It contains 53 ingredients. At the early beginning of Ayurveda, the main key ingredient was Swati Achirata, its main being Mohammed. It's later replaced by the Andrographis paniculata, its main hind being Kobe in Sri Lanka. So it contains Andrographis paniculata 50% along with other 52 ingredients. My main thing is that it has excellent properties, but it all together makes very, very bitter taste. So as I am an ayurvedic consultant pediatrician, I wanted to give these drugs to the pediatric patients. So it is impossible to excellent properties of these drugs were masked by the bitterness. So all together, all our team wanted to convert this powder into suspension. Finally, we converted the Sudarshana powder into suspension using Veesani according to the ayurvedic manapari bhasha. After that, we did lot of studies with the Sudarshana suspension and shelf life qualities. We assess pH value, relative density, microbial studies as well as DSC fingerprint, chromatographic studies. So all the doing, and it has found that it is not deteriorated during the period of 1 year. And also the safety study. It means acute and chronic toxicity studies was carried out within and also the long-term administration, it has revealed that it has no toxic effect, and it has found that it has a good antipyretic effect, acute anti-inflammatory effect, anti-nociceptive effect, anti-histamine effect, as well as the antioxidant effect when compared to the allopathic drugs. And also we have completed the phase 1 clinical trial on healthy elderly volunteers, and it has found it has a safe drug without any side effects. And also phase 2 clinical trials was carried out with the pediatric febrile patient with good effect with antipyretic effect. So today, normally that inflammatory response has received a great deal of interest in the field of medical research because inflammation and pain underlies the almost every disease. Therefore, the main aim of this study was to investigate the chronic anti-inflammatory response of Sudarshana suspension in Mr. Rats. Let's move to the methodology. Ethical clearance was obtained from the Ethics Review Committee, Faculty of Medical Sciences, University of Sudarshana. The chronic anti-inflammatory activity of Sudarshana suspension was determined using the adjuvant-induced arthritis TAC model. And healthy unused male histidates purchased from the Medical Research Institute. And cats were housed under the standardized animal house condition at the Faculty of Medical Sciences, University of Sudarshana. They had assessed the food WHO accepted food formula. It's mainly prepared the drugs according to the guideline of the WHO and water limit term. 24 heads were randomly divided into 4 groups, 6 tests in each. It means non-arthritic tests, health control group, and also the adjuvant-induced arthritis 3 groups, arthritic control, standard drugs, and fixed drugs. Drugs are given as follows. The dosage of test drugs were determined by calculating the dose for rats equivalent to the human adult normal doses, equivalent to human proportionate to the standard 60 kilograms. So let's move to the inductions of arthritis. Normally, arthritis was induced by the single intradermal injection of 0.1 milliliter of Fern's complete adjuvant into the foot pad of the hind paw of the rats. All the rats except the group 1, it means healthy group, we induced injection on the sterile saline for the normal rats, healthy rats. Then after drug administration, following the induction, arthritis and daily oral treatment was started on day 14 and continued up to day 28. Ankle joint thickness as well as the foot pad thickness were measured using the dial caliper, and also the body weight also measured, and day 0 and day 3, 7, 10, 14, 17, 21, 24 and 28. Full bed count was tested on day 28. Normally, percentage inhibition of elbow joint thickness as well as the foot pad thickness and the body weight gain was the calculator used in these formulas. This is the porcelain of the arthritis rats. Let's move to the statistical analysis. The data was expressed as the mean plus or minus standard error of mean. An untreated arthritis rats group was compared with the healthy control animals, and the treated arthritis groups were compared with the untreated arthritis animals. The significant levels was determined using the student t-test as follows. Let's move to the research and discussion. Chronic anti-inflammatory effect of body weight of the rats. It means the arthritis condition is associated with the weight loss due to systemic or local action of cytokine. Then arthritis injection. After the injection, there was no significant differences, changes in body weight as observed day 0 to day 7. The body weight is negative control rats were significantly increased compared with the healthy control group. Let's see the figure. According to the figure, that's the control group, there is a significant decrease in the arthritis control group. But after the drug administration on 14 days, that celecoxib group and Sudarshana suspension group, they increase their body weight gradually. Let's move the effect of Sudarshana suspension on ankle joint thickness. And there is no differences at the beginning, but only third day, as a first selling phase, there is somewhat increased ankle joint thickness. And thereafter, it is slowly subsided up to 7 days. And because of the, after the disseminated the arthritis, it increased again. Let's move to the picture. According to the picture, then celecoxib group and the Sudarshana suspension group significantly, extremely significantly reduced their ankle joint thickness in day 17, 21, 24 and 28. Let's move to the effect of Sudarshana suspension on foot pad thickness. It's also, there is no differences in day 4 to day 14, and also extremely significant effect was observed in the celecoxib group as on day 21, 24 and 28, as well as the Sudarshana suspension, extremely significant effect was observed in day 24 and 28. According to the effect of drugs in hematological indices of AIRS, there's no significant decrease observed. There was a significant decrease observed in the hemoglobin and RBC concentration in control group when compared to the healthy control rats. Let's move to the figure table. There's, it is clearly mentioned here there is a difference, a significant differences was observed in control groups in white blood cell, neutrophil, lymphocyte when compared to the healthy controls. as well as the red blood cells, and the hemoglobin was decreased significantly compared with the healthy control. When we started the treatments, that celecoxib group and Sudarshana suspension group significantly increased their white blood cells, neutrophils, as well as the lymphocytes according to the treatment. So, I would like it can be concluded that the novel preparation Sudarshana suspension possesses statistical significant chronic anti-inflammatory events comparable to the celecoxib. So, for this study was studies are being planned to evaluate the effects in human. These are my differences. I would like to take this opportunity to thank for the higher education for the 21st century HET program that they have support me as the financially. So, thank you very much for listening for my presentation.